Welcome back. This time we are going to make a quilling earring which can be used. You can wear it to functions and places out. It'll be very nice. So let's see what we need to make that quilling earring. First, I have taken black strips. I have taken 6 of them here, and then 3 of them I have divided into 3 and cut it. Then I have taken some green strips here. I have taken 4 of them. Then I have taken some blue strips. If you want, you can take the same color, green and blue. I have taken green and blue. You can take green or blue, green itself. Even this blue strips, I have cut it into 3 parts. Then we need a quilling tool. Then your glue. Then I have taken 2 hooks and 2 jump rings. Then I have taken the beads. I have taken 2 in same one color and then 6 in another color. You can also do the same. So now I have kept all the other things aside. I have taken 4 green color quilling strips, 6 black color quilling strips, and then glue and your quilling tool. So now keep everything aside. Take your quilling strips. First, take one green color strip. Keep the others aside. And then take one black color strip. Keep even this aside. Okay, now bring your glue. In the edge of this green color strip, apply a bit of glue. And then stick the black color strip there. And then press it. It has to stick well. Okay, so then take this other edge, apply some glue, keep it aside. Then bring another black color quilling strip and then stick it. Okay, so now take the edge of that black quilling strip, apply some glue there. Take your green color strip and then stick it. Okay, so move this and then take your green color strip, bring glue, apply some glue there at the edge, then bring your black strip and then stick it. So now actually I have taken more number of black color strips, that's why now totally in this entire line which I have stuck, now we have got 5 number of quilling strips. In that, 3 of them are black color and then 2 of them are green color. So now you'll have to bring in your quilling tool. So take this one edge of the line, it's black for me. So insert it into the quilling tool. Okay, so I have inserted inside this quilling strip just a little bit of paper. You'll have to fold it into this white part is here, no? So bring your glue and then apply a bit of glue there and then turn it. So that has to be stick there and you'll have to keep rolling it. Okay, so now I have taken this earring which we made out of the quilling tool. So now you'll have to bring glue and put it in this edge and then stick it. Now see, I've got a round like this, just like this, with the leftover paper. In the same order, you'll have to stick it with glue and you'll have to make it in this round and you'll have to bring it. Okay, so now I've got 2 circles here, as you can see. So now take one circle and then push it inside, from inside to out, push it a bit, not much. See, like this, in little bit up, as you can see. Then turn it, bring glue. You'll have to spread glue in it. Okay, so I have spread glue in this. Keeping it like this, you'll have to keep it to dry. Even for this other circle, you'll have to do the same. Okay, so now I've kept that circles to dry by pushing it a bit. Okay, now it's time to use this. I have taken 3 whole black quilling strips and I have divided into 3 and cut it. Then instead of green, the colors which you used for the circle, instead of green, here I am taking blue color. Even this, I have cut 2 strips. The third strip, I am going to show you. So, you'll have to keep this aside. Okay, so now this is the entire strip. So, first, you'll have to fold it in the middle. Like half. Okay, so now we have folded it. Open it. Then, here in this middle, there's a fold. The middle fold which you folded. Just for me, the fold is here. So, above that, a little bit, I am taking and I am folding it. Press it there. Okay, so now I have kept it like this. Then, this edge which is left over here, fold it and keep it. So now I have kept it like this. A little bit excess is there out here. So you have got the folds into 3. You have divided it and you have got the folds. So cut it in that folds. If you have got a bit excess also, no problem. So now you have divided the one quilling strip into 3 parts. Like this you will have to do the other things. Like that only I have made the other things which I showed before. So now you will have to bring the other strips also. Okay, so we have got the strips. I have cut it. So here I have cut 3 strips into 3 parts. So totally I have got 9 blue color sheets like this small. And then 9 black color strips like this, small strips. So from both of this, I've taken out one small strip, because we just require 8 small strips in both the colors. Okay, so now take one strip, one blue color and one black color. Keep the others aside. Bring these two, bring your glue. Now keep the black away and then in the blue color strip you will have to put some glue in the edge and then bring this and attach it there. Okay, so this has become one long strip, both of them you have attached. So now keep this aside. Like this, even for the other strips, everything you will have to keep one black and one blue strip and you will have to stick everything together. Okay, so now I have completed sticking all these papers, blue and black. So now you will have to take one sheet. I have taken one here. Keep the others aside. Bring in your quilling tool. Okay, so you will have to insert it. I have inserted it. Just like before, fold it inside. You will have to bring your glue. And then apply some glue there and then rotate it. So now you will have to keep rotating it just like before. So you will have to do like this for all the other sheets also. So now I have made all the circles. All the papers have been made into circles. So now you have to bring in these circles also. This has dried here. Okay, so now bring in your jump rings and hooks. You also need your glue for this step. Okay, so now let's start this step. You'll have to keep these things away. Take one hole. Okay, so now take one jump ring. Take this one small hole and then insert this jump ring into it. Okay, so I have inserted in one, as you can see. Okay, now take the other jump ring. You'll have to expand it a bit. Okay, so I've opened it. Now you'll have to take another circle like this, and you'll have to insert the jump ring. Okay, so I have inserted it. Now you'll have, since we made it open, now you'll have to close this also. Okay, so it has come like this. You should not close it completely. You need to leave a bit of gap. Now take your hook, and there's a bit of gap here, no? So through that you'll have to insert it. Okay, so now you have inserted the jump rings and hooks in both the earrings, and now you'll have to close that hole because it's a bit space was there and you inserted it. Now you'll have to close that. Okay, so I have closed in both of them. Now keep this aside, bring these circles, and then keep one aside. I'll show you how to do in one. You have to do the same thing in the other one too. Okay, so bring your glue, take a circle, apply some glue here. And then stick it. Okay, this is here. Then you'll have to take another circle, take your glue, apply some glue there, and stick it. Then you'll need one more circle. Take it, apply some glue, and then stick it. Okay, so now take this, which you have attached the hook and jump ring. Take it. Even in this, the down part, apply some glue. Then on top of these three, you'll have to stick it. Okay, so now it should be like this. Now it's been all have been sticked, so you'll have to allow it to rest. Do the same for the other circle too. Okay, so now it has dried. Wow, it's very nice. So we are going to add a final touch to this. So let's see what that final touch is. Okay, so for that final touch, we will require the earrings and your glue and as well as your beads. Okay, so now let's see how to do the final touch. So take your glue. First, I'm taking the green color bead. Okay, so you'll have to take it, apply some glue. I've applied the glue here, and then in the center, I've taken two green color beads, so I'm keeping it in the center. Okay, see, like this. So take your other bead, apply some glue, and then stick it. Okay, so it's very nice. And then take your other beads, and then you'll have to stick it in these three holes. So you can apply gum directly in this. Okay, then you'll have to press it a bit. So this is how the earring will be for me, and then like this itself, you'll have to stick it in this earring also. Okay guys, so our earring is ready. This is the one which we made right now, And these are the other ones which I made before. So if you have liked this video, please like, share, comment, and also if you're watching our channel for the first time, don't forget to subscribe. Thanks for watching.